In 1975, Italian keyboardist and producer Franco Falsini of the library space funk band Sensations Fix released a solo album that put him in the vanguard of pioneering electronic releases from Europe, outside the Berlin scene anyway. The album Cold Nose, or as it's spelled in Italian, Naso Freddo. And from that album, part two of the title's suite. Basically hearing two layers here. In this speaker, I'm hearing some guitar and... No, I scratched that. I'm hearing kind of some light, kind of vaguely frippertronic type guitar from my right speaker. And from my left speaker, I'm basically hearing this... You hear that? No, no, no. No, 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 no. And now kind of more of a fizzy sound is taken over in this speaker. I think there's like three things going on at a time. Oh, like a kind of like a wave, kind of like an oscillation is starting to take shape. How the fuzzy, kind of warm guitar tone is interacting with the fuzzy, warm synth tone. Like a 5/4. No. A lot of fizzy sounds in this, trebly sounds. I'd say most akin to what Zanov would be doing the following year, the following couple of years. Oh, now I'm hearing kind of like a luminous sound coming from below it, underneath the kind of fizzy, the kind of trebly sound. Or like the kind of wheezy sound, I should say. That one sound that's doing the slower chords, that kind of light sound. No, no, no. And then we've got these two sounds that are kind of competing with one another. One that's kind of lower than the other. Like a mixture of Ashra and Ashra Temple. Actually, because this is before either the Ashra albums or the Zanov, but you could say like a cross between Ashra Temple and Zanov. Yeah, because some of the guitar tones just now are the guitar moments are kind of reminding me of like the stuff on the two Ashra albums. Self-performed. I guess he did both the keyboards and the guitar. Part three. I'm going to play the first third of part three. Four, I think, or 10-8. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
one's more guitar dominated, like warm, sustained, fuzzy tones over like a just kind of a reoccurring theme in the background on keyboards. Yeah, the synth is really faint here. I'm hearing two guitar tracks. The tone that's coming out of this speaker, that higher, kind of ghostly, bending tone, is more kind of evocative of the sound that's often attributed to Robert Fripp. I once heard that sound referred to as the hollow metal tube sound, although I don't know really what that's referring to. Some kind of, like, effect. Now we've got three layers, and I'm not hearing any guitar now. It's all become keyboard. We've got that kind of lower going boom, 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 and we've got the higher tinkly sound. We got two of them kind of on the higher end. Seven, eight. Or it's alternating threes and fives, actually. So it's actually in four. Well. Sure if many of the other electronic artists use so many odd time signatures is what I've heard on this. That would be something to check. Like, it's not something off the top of my head, I really associate with Tangerine Dream or the Berlin School in general. Thank you. you've got the over that the really low ostinato, synth ostinato, we've got that like this kind of tinkly high end keyboard that's reflecting it. And then we've got in the middle that soloing instrument that was just a moment ago kind of fleshing out a melody here. I like how these pieces, though, there's basically kind of like a sequencer-driven pattern, and then you'll have like a bunch of tonal colors weaving in and out over that pattern, and every once in a while, one of the instruments will come in and flesh out more of a melody, like we were hearing. So we were hearing like a mixture of improvisation, sound shaping, tonal color, and actual some composition, some thematic play, all on just different variations of keyboards and guitar. And this piece could easily have been since it covers both the melodic, harmonic, and as well as the tonal areas. This could be more than just an electronic piece. This could easily be transferred over to, like a jazz rock band, and played with a much different set of arrangements and come out effective. That's not something that you can say about a lot of the tracks from the Berlin School that tend to be based more exclusively in just the sound shaping department. You know, that seem to be just entirely based on tonal color and don't have much in the way of melody coming through. Yeah. Franco Falsini, Naso Freddo, Cold Nose, his 1975 solo release on Polydor. Otherwise very busy during that time frame, putting out roughly two albums a year with Sensations Fix between 1974 and 1978, and then a seventh album, I guess, is Sheriff, when Sensations Fix tried to disguise themselves as a West Coast band. Yeah. For more Rubies and Sapphires from this, or basically to see the breakdown of this album and the Sensations Fix album, see the directory of albums by Italian artists linked in the description below. For Red Hot Tracks and Tasty Purples from the Sensations Fix catalog, as well as many other similar artists, you know, in the Italian library vein, the electronic vein, well, the few electronic artists from Italy, like Franco Falsini and Electricus, as well as many other areas of music from that great nation. And like and subscribe and follow me on social media and leave a comment if there are any observations you have about the music that we heard here, the layers, the effects, the keyboards that were most likely used to produce these sounds and the effects that were used to produce the guitar sounds we heard. And until next time, this is Zaragon, the world's most ear-traveled trimaximalist, signing off.